Subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video.
Can I ask you a question, Father? Do you know anything about La Llorona?
The Weeping Woman.
It's a folk tale.
To some.
Hi everyone, welcome to my channel, The HowStation. My name is Tanvi, and for today's final video for Halloween, I have turned myself into Llorona, the Weeping Woman. So I recently saw the teaser trailer for Llorona, the Curse of La Llorona. And Llorona was shown in the almost 2.5 minute trailer just for a split second. So I took a screenshot of that split second and I thought that I'm doing this for Halloween. So I took inspiration from there. I haven't copied the whole look. I have done a little bit of my own bits and pieces in here. And I took inspiration from that one little split second picture. And I've created this look. So I was going to do the nun first actually, but then I saw a post on Instagram saying move over the nun, Llorona the Weeping Woman is here. So I thought that this is actually good, you know, to do Llorona, because we've been watching the nun since Conjuring 2 and many of them have done looks inspired by the nun. So I thought ki usko thoda baju mein rakke Llorona ko thoda exposure de dete. Isliye here is the look that I've done inspired by Llorona, and I really love the name and I really love to say it in this way, Llorona. Yeah, so I'm going to show you how I turned myself into Llorona, or how I did the look inspired by Llorona. And without wasting any more time, let's begin with the video. I've put in contact lenses and now I'm going to start doing my face makeup. The first thing, I'm going to apply foundation. I've mixed in a little bit of yellow acrylic paint in the foundation, which is diluted with a little bit of water. I added the yellow because I wanted a little bit of yellowish tint to my foundation, and diluting it with water is necessary, otherwise it is going to dry down and leave streaks on your face. After the first layer of foundation, I added a little bit more yellow in my foundation because I wasn't happy with how the first layer looked, and then I applied that all over my face. I know my face is looking as though I've applied turmeric paste, but that's okay because the foundation does settle down to a much normal color later on. After I'm done with foundation, I'm going to work on the eyes. I'm going to take a coal pencil and I'm going to apply it in my waterline and I'm going to smudge it like really well. I want my eyes to look very black. I'm going to apply the black on my eyelids as well. I'm just going to smear it all over so that my eyes look like really dark and black. So as you can see, I'm not following any proper technique or no blending or anything. I'm just like spreading it, smashing it all over my face and just leaving it there. Next, I'm going to take some maroon eyeshadow and I'm going to create the hollows of my cheeks so that my face looks dead. And then with some black and maroon eyeshadow, I'm going to create bruises on my face and neck. Then using a tiny brush and some black eyeshadow, I'm going to create cracks on my face. I'm just going randomly all over my face. And yeah, I just decided to remove that center one because I wasn't happy with that. After the cracks on my face, I'm also going to create some cracks on my lips with black like this. And then I'm going to turn my lips into this weird pout like thing, and then I'm going to apply a black lipstick in the inner part of my lips. Then I'm going to take some maroon eyeshadow and I'm going to smudge it on my lips to make them appear dead and rotten. So makeup is done, and now the last thing remaining are the tears. I'm going to take some red lipstick on the back of my hand like this, and then I'm going to take clear eyelash glue and put that as well on the back of my hand. Mix the two together, and with a brush I am going to draw the tears like this from my eyes right down to my chin. And now this is almost done. The last thing, again, I've got this charcoal made from burnt coconut. I'm going to apply that all over my teeth. And with that, this completes my Halloween look for today, inspired by Llorona. So guys, that was my look inspired by Llorona, the crying woman or the weeping woman. And this is the makeup I put on, an old white t-shirt, and this is like a mesh cloth which I had in my house. It's like just a small piece. I've put it on my head and I've added bobby pins to it so that it stays on my head. And yeah, so this was the video in which I turned myself into Llorona. Comment down below how many times I said Llorona. And yeah, so that's it for today's video. I hope you all enjoyed watching it. The makeup is very easy. You can do this like last minute for Halloween. And yeah, you can turn yourself into Llorona. And that's it. So if you all enjoyed watching the video, you know what to do. Please hit the like button, share the video with your friends and family so that even they can watch it and turn themselves into Llorona. And comment in the comments down below on how you thought the video was, if there are any other video requests or feedback suggestions or what else, yeah, anything, whatever you thought about the video, you can comment that in the comments down below. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and if you have already subscribed, then make sure that you have the notifications turned on by pressing the little bell icon which is right next to the subscribe button. And yeah, that's it for today. I'll see you guys in my next video. Until then, have a good day, take care, and goodbye.